Good afternoon, everyone. Rahul and Dhamaraju and our trainer, Mr. Abdul. We'll start a session now. The others may join in between. So welcome to this session, and we are going to talk about SAP HANA Admin 2.0. And we have our trainer, Mr. Abdul, who is an experienced and certified consultant. And whatever queries you may have concerning the subject, please be free and ask whatever questions you all want to. So, Mr. Abdul, up to you now. I'll be on mute.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks, Sunny. Yeah, hi, everyone. This is Abdul. Let me introduce myself. I'm having around 18 plus years of experience in SAP Basis and HANA. I have worked on the multiple implementation upgrade migrations project and the support as well. I'm working in one of the MNC organizations, and Saturday, Sunday, I'm providing a training on the HANA Admin, HANA Security in the basis. So that's all about myself. Can you guys introduce yourself, and can you give me some backgrounds, what you're doing exactly, and what is your backgrounds? Can we start with the Dhamaraju first?
Yeah, hi. I'm working as a basis consultant. So I have little knowledge on HANA, but not much. So I want to.
Okay.
I have 9 years experience on basis.
Okay. So you, what do you know in the HANA? So have you worked on the HANA database?
No.
Okay.
Theoretical knowledge.
Okay. Fine. Thanks, Raju. Rahul, can you give me some backgrounds yourself?
Hi, this is Rahul here. I have a total 3 years of experience into SAP Basis, and since I don't have a HANA exposure, so I have thought to go for HANA learning.
Wow. Okay. Great. Yeah, it is good time to learn in the lockdown, because we all at home, so we can. Yeah, it's a good time to utilize time for the learning. Yeah, so let's start. What I'm going to cover. Yeah, good. Any question? Okay, fine. So let's start. What I'm going to cover in HANA Admin 2.0. So it is totally related to a database training, HANA DBA training. Okay, so whatever we do in the basis. Okay, so apart from that, we have to learn the HANA Admin as well. If you are a basis consultant, then it is mandatory to learn to understand the HANA database. Okay, so same like if you are running SAP on the Oracles, there we require the Oracle expertise. Yeah, so but Oracles, we cannot compare Oracle with the HANA database. So if you are running SAP on HANA database, then the HANA database is very huge topic in the HANA. Okay, so we'll see that what I'm going to cover. So if you see my course content, so first will be introduction to HANA database. What is HANA database? What is the architectures of the HANA database? What is in-memory concept in the database? What is the single host and multi-node cluster configuration? Multi-node means distributed installations architectures. So how we install the distributed database in the SAP. Okay, that architecture will see that, and also in that introduction we will see the persistence layer. So in HANA database we have two types of persistence layer. So persistence layer is nothing but storing the your data. So initially the data is stored in the memory, and then after that it is written to a disk. So primary persistence in the HANA database is a memory, and the secondary persistence layer is nothing but the disk, that is the data volumes or log volumes. So we have two storage in the persistence layer, primary and the secondary. Primary is the memory and the secondary is the disk. Okay, we'll cover more that in the introduction of SAP HANA database, and then after that we'll start the preparation of the installations. So before installation, what we have to do, we do the sizing of the HANA database, we do the sizing of the memory, we do the sizing of the RAM, that is memory, we do the sizing of the CPU, we do the sizing of the desk. Okay, so those we will see how to size the HANA database for the green field, how to size the HANA database for brown field. So when I green field, it is a new implementation, how to size your database for new implementation, how to size your BW or CSS in the Oracle database or some other data, and you want more to HANA, then how you'll do this sizing, that we will cover in the preparing the in the preparation phase. Okay, once the sizing and everything is done, then we go for the installation. We'll go for the installation. So in that we'll see how we install HANA database and the installations methods. So we have the, you know, command line method, we have this GUI we have web based methods. So we will see that the HANA database. So we have been tools life cycle in HANA database. We have the life cycle management tools. So we have management tools, life cycle management and the application lifecycle management tools. So basically the platform lifecycle management tools are used for installation and the upgrade of your HANA database. When I say upgrading, then upgrading the HANA database 1.2.0 upgrade, review upgrade from 0 to 0, support package revision upgrade, maintenance revision upgrade. Those all will done through the platform lifecycle management tools. Application lifecycle management tools are used for, you know, maintaining the one HANA database to another HANA database. So those will come under the application lifecycle management tools. Yeah, we'll see more detail in the installation relations. Yeah, and then after that we'll cover the post installation steps. So what are the the post installation we have to do after installation of the HANA database. So like we have to install the license. So what are the types of license we have in the HANA database? Temporary license, permanent license. We have two types of license, and what is the in the permanent license, we have two types of license in the permanent as well. So we'll cover more in detail, and then how to do the support pack upgrade. Okay, how to update your HANA database, yeah, and revision upgrade or maintenance revision, or the HANA upgrading from positions. Administrative tools, we'll see that admin tools are available for us for monitoring and troubleshooting. Okay, so we have the HANA Studio, we have the cockpit, we have the DBA cockpit. Okay, we'll see that more, and then after that we'll cover the HANA operations. Okay, so what day-to-day operations, what we are doing in the day-to-day operations, that we will see how to start and stop the HANA database. Okay, and what are the configurations tasks we do in the HANA database. Okay, those we'll see, and day-to-day activity, weekly activity, monthly activity, whatever we do as a part of monitoring, as a part of the support the project, that we will see in the HANA operations. So in the HANA operations we'll see the monitorings, troubleshooting, and day-to-day operations, weekly operations, and the monthly operations for housekeeping jobs and all that. We will cover everything in the HANA HANA operations topic. Then memory management. Okay, so how the memory is managed in the HANA database. So all the data is stored in the memory. Okay, how the memory is managed in the HANA database. So we have the delta merge, how the delta merge operation is happen, what is the process of the delta merge, why the delta merge is there in that in the HANA database. So we'll see more the memory management, same like in the ACP. Someone is left out. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so HANA memory management, in that we'll see that how the memory is managed, what are the parameters, what are the process we have. Okay, that we will see in the memory management. Plus we'll see the how the when the HANA database started. Okay, so what is the sequence of this startup sequence in the HANA database? What are the process? Start first. you know, during the startup, and what are the process stop during the you know, stopping the 100. So basically we will see the startup sequence and the shutdown sequence of the HANA database. So that is more important in terms of, you know, troubleshooting. Okay, also we'll see that technical deployment options. Okay, so in the HANA database we have, you know, multiple technical deployment options. So how you can install, how you can define or design your you know, hardware and the VMs for the HANA installations, whether you are going to install the multiple SIDs on one servers, that is a one VM or one hardware, or you will be using the, you know, one database systems, and in that you will be using a, you know, multiple SIDs. Okay, something kind of that we will see more in detail in the technical deployment options. So this is the important in terms of you are working as a technical architect. So you have to define your you know, HANA deployment options. Yeah, so if you see the latest, we have the multi data container. So HANA 2.0 is supported you know, by default it has the multi data container. So basically now everyone in a, you know every customer is now using the multi data container. So SCOS, MCOS, MCOD is now, you know, very old. Now we have the new one, that is the multi data container. So in that multi data container we can have the multiple tenant database, one system db, we have one system db and multiple data container. So basically the system db are used for, you know, managing and maintaining the your tenant database. So using the system db you can start and stop your tenant database. Yeah, so multiple tenant database we can have in one HANA database systems in case of you have multi data containers. So basically 2.0 have by default multi data container. So when you install HANA 2.0, it installed by default as a multi data container. So HANA 1.0 is a single containers. Okay, in that you can have only one database, but in the 2.0 you can have the multiple tenant, multiple database, that we call a tenant database. Then we'll cover the backup and recovery as well. Okay, so this how we can, how we perform a backup of HANA database, how we restore the HANA database. So if you are working on a, you know, refresh kind of activity, like refresh, or you know, if you are you know, creating a copy of your production environment as a, you know, sandbox or as a, you know, the quality systems, then how you can you know, achieve those things using the backup and recovery, you can do that as well. So you can take a backup and you can restore that on your quality or some other you know, systems. Okay, so basically backup and recovery we use you know, creating a, you know, POC systems, you know, you know, creating a one more quality or sandbox systems for the you know, upgrade or any kind of activity we do. Okay, so we'll see more how we take a backups, how we recover the HANA database. We'll see more in detail. Then another topic we will cover, the users and the authorization. So HANA security. So HANA security, how you can create a users in the HANA database, and how you can assign the authorizations to the newly created users, that we will see in the, you know, users and the authorization. So in that we'll see how to create a users, how to create a roles, how to assign our users to our roles. Okay, types of privileges. So privileges is nothing but the authorizations. So if you are compared with the SAP application, so in SAP application we call authorizations, but in the DB level we call our privileges. Yeah, then multi-data container, we'll cover the, you know, multi-database container. So what is the multi-data container in HANA 1.0, HANA 2.0, that we will cover, and we will compare single tenant with multi-tenant database. Okay, also we'll see that how to administer, how to monitor your tenant database. So administration of your multi-tenant database, like, you know, creating of the tenant database, you know, dropping of a tenant database. Okay, starting and restarting of your tenant database, starting stopping of the tenant database. Those we will see. Also, we'll see that how to perform a backup and recovery of the tenant database in the multi-tenant database containers. Okay. After this, we will also cover the HA, high availability, and the disaster recovery. Okay, so before that, we have to understand the scalability concept. So we have scale up and the scale out concept in the HANA database. We'll see more in the session. So also, so how you can configure your HANA database for the HA and for your for the DR, that we will also we will cover in the session. Okay, so. So for the HA and the DR, we have the HANA system replication. Okay, if we have the host auto failover mechanisms. Okay, so those we will see. So this part will be theory. Okay, so high availability and the disaster recovery will be part of theory, and the HANA system replication. I will show you the how commands and the PPT. The documents, how we can configure the HANA system replications for the HA or DR scenario. We'll see more in detail HANA system replication. This is very important for the if you're working as a SAP basis plus HANA admin. So this HANA system replication is very important. So we'll see more detail on the replications. Host auto failover, this is also one type of the HA. Okay, so basically this is used if you have distributed environments. So distributed environment means you are running multiple nodes in one HANA database, and in that one node is standby node. Okay, so that concept we call SAP HANA host auto failover. If any active node fails, then the standby node will take the ownership of the failed node. So the standby node take over the failed active nodes. So standby node become a active if the standby see any node is failed in the HANA database systems. Yeah, and then after that last topic we will cover that the migrations, that is the DMO. So this DMO is also a theory. So this two part will be a theory. Okay, so how we use DMO for the migration of your HANA database from any database. For example, if you are running HANA database, if you are running any SAP application on the SQL database or IBM DB2 or Oracle, and you want to migrate to the HANA database, then how you will do. So we have the DMO. Okay, so using the DMO tools, we can migrate any database to the HANA database. So that we'll see in the migration of the HANA database. So basically, this is my course content. So this all totally related to your HANA admin 2.0. So we will be covering this for HANA 2.0 and. So in HANA 2.0 we have the latest SPS is SPS 4 that I will going to on SPS 4 I will going to teach you this topic. Yeah, any questions, any doubt on the course, guys?
Hi Abdul, this is Rahul here.
Yeah.
Abdul, I just wanted to know, as you said, for system replication, you will be going through a document or you can say a presentation. That's fine, no issues. But how about for DMOs? You will go for DMO as well with the document, or you will just let us know the practical scenarios as well?
Yeah, DMO practically is not possible because DMO required a migration key. Yeah, so whenever we change our OS or database, then it asks for the migration key, and migration key it is not free, so we have to get it from the ACP. Yeah. So yeah, so
it's it is not free. That's the reason I thought to confirm.
Yeah, so that's the reason I told that it is practical is not possible. So on documents, I can provide you the informations like whatever I had it for the project. So those I can share on the PPT and all that. Yeah. So
That means you will be having all those screenshots and the theoretical part, yeah. Right?
Correct. Yeah. Correct. All the project related whatever I have done on the projects. So I have the screenshot and all that. HANA system replication HADR is also not possible because for doing the HADR we should have the huge infrastructures and plus two DR systems kind of so those also not possible practically. So that's those I can cover on a PPT how to configure. So I have the screenshot and everything. So it is very simple. So theory part is very more important in the replications. Configuration is only 5 to 6 steps. So if you remember those 5 to 6 commands, then you can easily you can configure.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
Any other questions, guys? Raju and Atul.
Abdul, no, not as such. Yeah. So, same thing what Rahul also told that, the practical part, what we'll see will be quite less basically, what I understand from it.
Yeah, for the DMOs, practical DMO is not possible because DMOs require a, migration scheme. And the system replication, I will try to get the practical, so I'll get it. So so HANA system replication, we can do the practical. So I can arrange the servers, two servers for the HA part. So HANA system replication, I can manage for the practical, but for the migration is not possible.
So otherwise, we'll get a server access for any of the whatever activities we are doing for test.
You will get the server access. Yeah.
Okay. That's 2.0.
Server will be available. Correct. 2.0 SPA04, latest one.
Okay. Fine.
So whatever I'll teach, that is the latest one. So whatever the new things comes and new things I learn, I update my course contents. Yeah. So everything
and,
is latest.
What is the duration? Yeah, what's the duration this thing, Abdul, for this one course, like total?
25 to 30 hours. Yeah, 25 to 30 hours total course durations in between. Maximum 30
so
hours
we
can consider.
Yeah, so we are planning for daily. How is that? Because I didn't know that. It's a daily you'll be taking?
Daily is not possible for me now. Because the morning batch, okay. I have occupied with the morning batch. So Saturday, Sunday, we can take it.
Okay, Saturday, Sunday, you're playing. So 1 hour each or what? Or 2 hours?
Two hours, Saturday, 2 hours, Sunday.
Sunday, okay. Fine.
Yeah, so 4 hours per week.
And what are the charges like? If I don't know, maybe.
Sunny can guide you on that one. Charges, but to technical parts, I can cover.
Okay.
Commercial parts, Sunny can,
Okay. Fine. Yeah. Sure, no worries. Thanks, sir.
Yeah, Raju, any questions from you, Tamaraju?
No, sir.
Yeah. So I will show you that how the HANA database look and feels. So if you have not seen, then I'll show you that. So basically we have the HANA Studio. Yeah. So HANA Studio is the graphical user interface which is installed on the user's side. That is on the user's laptop or desktops. So here I have installed SAP HANA Studio. Okay, just double click on that. So basically HANA Studio is used to connect the HANA database. So it is same like SAP GUI. In SAP GUI, we use to connect our SAP systems. Okay, so there we create entries for SAP applications. And then when we double click, it asks for the user ID and the password. Same thing we have in the HANA, that is the HANA Studio, which is used to connect to HANA database. So this is the HANA Studio. Here we have to create a connections. Okay, so it is blank, nothing is there. So how to add the systems? Here we have the add systems. Here we using this pattern, we can add the HANA database. Okay, so we have to create a entries for the HANA database. So here you have to type the host name or IP address of the HANA database. So here is my IP 35.238.65.231, and the instance number is the 01. So it is database instance number, HANA database instance number. And here you have to select single container or multi container. So HANA 1.0 is the single containers and HANA 2.0 is the multi containers. So nowadays we have the HANA 2.0 latest one SP04 in that, and it is by default it is a multi containers. You have to select here multi containers, and then here you have to decide whether you want to connect your tenant database or system DB. Okay, so basically the tenant database is used. So we will connect tenant database. System DB is used for basically, you know, monitoring and managing your tenant database. So here you have to provide your SIDs of your tenant database. So here is DEV, and then click next. And then here you have to provide users. So I'm going to use system users. Okay, this is the DB users. It is there in the HANA database, and the password for that DB users, and then click on the finish. So it will create entries and it will get connected to the HANA database. The entry will be created here. Yeah. So now we see I have connected to the HANA database. My SID is DEV, Dev. So if we see that we have the four folders, catalog, content, provisioning, and the security. So what is use of these folders and the backup? Backup is used for, you know, to see the status of your backup. So backup status you can see in the backup folders. Okay, your database backup, okay, log backup and the data backups. In the catalogs, so basically the backup folder is used by the, you know, HANA admin team or basis team. They use and monitor the backups. Okay, the catalog folders are used by the developers. Under the catalog we have the schema. So this schema can be created by the developers or HANA admin, depends upon the roles and responsibility in the organizations. Yeah, so these all are the schema. If you see, these all are the schema, and under the schema what we have columns, EPA modules, function, index, procedures, sequence, tables, triggers, views. So basically under the schema we have the tables, views, function modules, procedures, triggers. So these are the object of your schema. So basically this all object will be holding the user's data. Okay, so under the schema we have these all the object. So if you see that under the tables, we have tables under the schema sys. So basically this is used by the HANA developers. They create a tables. Okay, they develop their object. Okay, so table, it can be a columns to tables or rows to tables. Yeah, so these are the tables. If you see, these are the tables. So tables, it is column tables and the rows to tables. Yeah, fine. Next, content. So basically content is used by the native HANA developers like BW team. Okay, so basically under the content they create a packages. Under the packages they create a sub package, and under the package or sub package they create their, you know, modeling views, modeling object. So we have different types of object in the content. Like object means views. So we have the information views, we have the calculations view, we have attribute views, we have decision tables. Yeah, so these all are related to the, you know, BW team. Okay, so they do native development on the content folders. So this is used by the BW team for native HANA development. Under this, if you expand this, this is the SAP standard public SAP system local. So these are the standard one. So this is public folder. It is a package. Under that public, we have a sub package called SAP, and under that we will be having the, you know, sub packages, and then under that we can have, this is also package, and if we expand, then this is also sub packages. So these are the SAP standard, and the under that you can see the, you know, views. So it is very the. So if you see that, this is the views. These are the views. So it has the content, the hidden objects. So under that, you can see our views. So it is SAP, you know, standard. If you expand, then you will, you know, it is very big. Okay. So under that, they can create. So I will show you that one other package by creating a one package. So just click on the right click on the content, and then click on the new, and then package. And then you can give the package name test, whatever you want. And then if you see under the test, we don't have anything. Now under the test package, we can create a sub package, and we can create a views, attribute views, analytical views, calculation views, analytical privileges, procedures, decision tables. So this all part is related to the BW team. They do this kind of, they design this kind of object in the under the content folder. Under the content folders, another is the provisioning. So under the provisionings, we have the smart data and the remote source systems. So basically the provisioning is used by the, you know, HANA admin team or basis team. So basically they connect to, you know, source systems. So source systems, it can be anything, SQL, non-SAP systems or SAP systems. Okay, so here they create up your connections to the remote database. It can be Oracle, it can be SQL, it can be anything. It can be HANA, it can be IQ database, Sybase database. Okay, to fetch the data in the HANA database, to fetch the, to duplicate the data from multiple source to HANA database through the smart data access, that we call a data provisioning. So this all configuration is done by the basis team or HANA admin team. Okay, so here you can see the list of the remote source systems which is connected to your database. So this is used for replicating a data into the HANA database from multiple source systems. The next is the security folders. So basically this security folder is used by, you know, HANA security or sometime the HANA admin as well. If the HANA, the security consultant is not there in the project or organizations, then the HANA admin take care the security part as well. Okay, if they have the knowledge on the security. So basically it is used by security consultant and the, you know, basis or HANA admin team. Okay, under that we create a users, we create a roles. Okay, under the users, under the roles, we can have the assign the, you know, privileges. So privileges is nothing but, you know, authorization. If you compare with the SAP applications, so in the SAP application we call authorizations, but in the database, HANA database, we call a privileges. So basically privileges control the access on the database. If you have the privileges, then you can perform the actions in the database. So required actions, required privileges is required. If you see here, we use users and the rules. So if you expand this users, so we have the predefined users. So these are the technical users, which is, you know, installed or created by default, you know, after the installations. Yeah, we have the roles, we have the predefined roles. So so here roles, we have two types of roles here, catalog roles and the, you know, repository roles. So these all are the, you know, predefined roles which comes by default in the HANA database after the installations. Under the security folders, we have the security files. So basically, this security is used for, you know, managing the password policies, enabling and disabling the audit, okay, and also configuring the SAML SSO and the, you know, data volumes encryption as well. Okay, so if you see that first step, audit, here you can enable and disable the audit, and then here you can define the password policies, audit policy, what, you know, what action you want to record, that you can define here. Okay, here the password policies, you can define the password policies, okay, for your database. Okay, so like, you know, last use password, initial password, lifetime, 7 days, something. So whatever the password policy we define for the application side, the same password policy we can define at the, you know, HANA database through the HANA Studio. SAML identity providers. So basically here we, this tab is used for configuring a SAML SSO. Okay, so here we import the SAML certificates, okay, in the HANA database. Yeah, after import you will get the entries here. Data volume encryption is used to enable the encryptions on the data volumes. So basically data volumes is nothing but your disk. So if you enable the encryption on your data volumes, so your data will be protected from unauthorized access from the OS level. Yeah, so basically it is recommendations from the SAP, you enable the data volume encryptions. Yeah, so how to enable, you just click here and then it will enable. So it will take a time. So before enabling the, you know, encryptions, we have to take a, you know, database backup first, and then we enable, you know, by taking a downtime. So downtime is required, we have to shut down the applications, yeah, and then we have to enable the data volumes. Fine. Okay, this is all about the, you know, HANA Studio folders. Okay, so monitoring tool is there, administrative. So monitoring administrative console is there, which is used by the, you know, HANA admin and the basis team. Okay, so how you'll open the HANA administrative tools? So click on your SIDs, double click on the SIDs, this one, dev underscore dev, double click here, it will open the administrative console. Basically, this is used by the, you know, HANA admin and the basis team, where they monitor your entire database. So using this tool, you can monitor. So basically, HANA Studio is used by all the people, you know, HANA developers, HANA admin, basis, HANA security. Okay, so they have the, you know, they have their own roles and responsibility. If you have the access, then you can monitor. If you have the access for creating a contents or fold the packages, then you can. If you have access for users creation and the role creations, then you can, you know, create a users and the roles. If you see the overview tab, so in that overview, it will show you the, you know, system informations. So if you see, system users is development systems, the startup date, so today it is started April 18, yeah. And then whether the system is distributed or single, so it is single systems, so only the one system is there, one host is there. Okay, so version for the HANA database, it is HANA 2.0 support pack 4, that is the latest, SP4, that is the latest. Okay, and when it was built, it is built on March 27. Okay, here it is showing the platform, so it is installed on the SUSE Linux Enterprise, okay, SP12, SP1, yeah. Here, the kernel version of the HANA database and the hardware manufacturers, it is on the Google Cloud. So it's showing the Google Cloud. If it is on VMs, then it will show you the VMs. If it is on a physical servers like HP, Dell, or Fujitsu or something, then here those details will be visible here. Here we have the HANA's used memory. So this is the used memory by the HANA database. Okay, so right now it is used around peak uses, maximum use is 8 GB. So total is allocated is 28 GB to HANA database. This is the resident memory, is nothing but the physical memory, used total physical memory by the HANA database plus other processes. You can see those details here. Here we have the CPU utilizations. You can monitor the CPU utilizations. So it is in the percentage, not in the numbers. So this is in the percentage, 100% out of 100%, only, you know, 5% is used maximum and the current is 2%. Here we have the disk uses. Here we can monitor the, you know, file systems or data volumes and the log volume trace. Okay, mount point, here you can see your size of the data. Okay, so here you can monitor your database size, database volumes and all that. Yeah, here in the landscape, if you go in the landscape, here you can see the services. Okay, so these are the services of the HANA database. Okay, so we have the compiles, daemon, index servers, name servers, preprocessors, web dispatcher, XX engine. So these are part of your HANA database. So these are the services which is available in the HANA database. So all are active. Here alert, you can see the alerts. So whatever the alert is generated in the HANA database, those you can see over here. Yeah. So whatever the alert is generated in the HANA database, that you can, you know, visible here. So we monitor as a business consultant or HANA admin. So we daily monitors the alert, and then based on that alerts, we take the actions. Performance. Under the performance, you can monitor the trades and the session. It is same like, you know, SAP, SM50 and SM66. There we monitor the processes. So here's the same thing we do in the HANA database, trades and session monitorings. We can, you know, we can monitor the long running trades and the session. Yeah. So this is the duration. Based on this, you can monitor your long running sessions. Yeah. So this is the application users. Yeah, which application users is, you know, utilizing the more memory or more time. Yeah, that you can do in the trades and the sessions. Okay, here if you go in the configurations, so in the configuration, basically we configure the HANA database. So in HANA database, we have the INI files. So basically these INI files are used for configuration purpose. So if you want to change any parameters for HANA database, then we have to change the parameters in this, all the profiles, not all. So whatever the profiles, whatever the parameters is applicable, wherever parameters is applicable, we do changes over here. For example, in the global.ini, if you want to take a, if you want to configure the backup, destination backups. Okay, for example, you have the file systems like backup file systems, and you want to take a, you want to, you know, take a backup on that particular separate the file systems called, you know, backup file systems, then that you can configure in the global.ini. So in that we have the persistence section. Under that, if you expand, then here we have the data backup. So here you have to define the location for the database, for the location of your the backup file systems. Okay, you have to define your target, the file system where the backup will store. Whenever you trigger a backup, the backup will go in that folders or file systems. For example, so I have, for example, file systems called backup file systems. So whenever the, you know, backup will happen, the backup will go, my data backup will go in the backup file systems. Yeah, so if I click on the save, then it will save it. Okay, so yeah, so here you can configure like this. So it is same like, you know, profile files in the SAP. We have different types of profiles in the SAP: instance profiles, then ACS profile, and then default profiles. So there we, you know, maintain the parameters. So same thing we can do in the HANA database in the INI files. Yeah, so we have the global.ini file, we have the index servers.ini files. Yeah, So global.inf file and the index server.inf file basically mostly use. So we can also configure the workload. We can configure this number of CPU, number of maximum amount of memory used by the HANA database. Those we can configure for tenant database and the system DB. Okay. If you go in the diagnostic files, if you go in a diagnostic tabs, so here all the alerts are generated. So whatever the alerts we get in the HANA database, those alerts we can see here. So alert means the trace files. So for each and every services, like we have the services, here we have the services. Yeah. So each and every services, whenever the services start and stop, that time, the trace file is generated for each and every services. For like example, we have the index server XX engine. Yeah. Then yeah. So whenever the services are start and stop, this trace file is getting updated. So log is written to the this one. So it is same like the work directory. So in the SAP we have the work directory where we check the logs for the dispatchers or the work process or message servers or in queue server. If it is not starting or some issues is there in the systems, then we check those log files under the work directory. So here we call a trace. Okay, so from the OS level you can also check it. So trace folder is there, the location for the trace folders you can check it from the OS level as well. Trace configuration is there. So by default, when we install the HANA database, so by default database trace is on. So this database trace, so by default this database trace by default it is enabled. Okay, by default it is enabled. So others trace are deactivated. So other trace we can enable based on the our requirement. But here database trace is always by default it is active. Okay, and therefore it is writing a log. So database trace enabled by default means it is writing a logs for all your services which is there in the HANA database. So if you disable this one, then it won't enable the write a logs in the diagnostic files. So you don't write any trace file for your services if you disable this one. It is not advisable to disable the database trace. So by default the database trace is on for your all the database services. So whenever you whenever the database start and stop, that time the those trace file is getting updated. I'm not going to stop anything. So this is all about the introduction of the HANA Studio. So this was only just why I wanted to show you that how HANA database look and feel from the HANA Studio if you are not seeing that one. Any questions here guys?
Abdul. Do we get to see the HANA installation here? See the HANA installation?
Yes.
Fresh
even correct face. Even you can install it. So I will show you the installations and then you can also do a practice. So that's the reason I told that you will be getting a dedicated servers. So that dedicated servers for you, you can do anything in that one. So on installation, you can install, you can uninstall, you can upgrade your HANA database, everything you can do it. You can take a backup, you can do a recovery.
Restore and all.
You can do everything you can do. Everything, because we will be using a dedicated. So other people, if you see that they use the shared servers and in that you won't do much activity. It is a dedicated servers.
Fine. Right. So I think the whatever practically activities we'll be doing, it's a major part of HANA admin. I mean, apart from the migration part, this part will also cover most of the support activities what normally people do, right?
Correct.
Okay, Abdul. Okay, thanks.
Any other question, guys? From Rahul, from Damaraju?
No questions as such from my end, Rahul.
Okay, thanks, Rahul. Okay. Thanks, guys. So, Sunny, we are good to close the session. Sunny, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Yes. So next, Damaraju, any questions to you before we end up? We close the meeting.
No.
Okay, so I will be sending you all this session, you know, so that you all can go through it. I've got some request. We'll be communicating after this. If you have any doubts later on, you can let me know and we'll try to see how we can resolve those queries of yours. So any question last time? Anyone? All right, everyone, thank you so much. You all have a great day and we'll be in touch. Thank you for your time. Thank you.
Thanks all.
Bye.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Abdul.
Yeah. Thanks all.